I'm Jonathan Kelly. I am a beef arable farmer from outside Limavady, Northern Ireland. We currently farm 300 hectares of a mixed farm between wheat, barley, oilseed rape, maize and rye, along with grass for cattle. Looking to upgrade our fertiliser spreader, and I have been on the phone to Derek from Limken. He's on his way to see me right now. Thank you very much, Derek, for coming. After a conversation last week, you know what I'm after. I'm looking for a 27 meter width with variable control, border control, section control, and a 3-ton capacity.
We're very lucky that we actually have Polaris 14 on demo at the moment, right? I've got a guy organised from McAlary's to bring one out to you here, so it should be here in a few minutes. So hopefully once they get here, we can actually show you through the spreader.
Right, okay, thank you.
Right, so we've had a look inside in the cab, seen what's going on inside there.
Yeah.
Again, this is the Polaris 14 model, okay? We've got 3-ton capacity here. She's a narrow-bodied machine, okay? The vanes on this particular machine here, 24 to 36 meters, so ideal for what you want to do at 27 meter. If you look at this here, this particular vein here, that's for your border spread. So how we work our border spread is that when you choose to use it, the actuator here will actually place the fertilizer into that, and that's what controls your spread width.
Right, okay.
Under normal conditions then, the actuator, which is here, is positioning the fertilizer using the drop point to where you want to do it. So that's how you determine your width. Okay, again, if you look at all the components, everything around here, stainless steel, very easy to access. You've got no hidden points for dirt to build up. You've got your main gearbox drive that comes up here, straight through to your disc. You can actually remove the disc quite easily if you don't want to change it or for maintenance. Everything can be moved around. Bladder, get to check inside the hopper, okay? Inside the hopper then, our agitators are actually two oscillating agitators. They don't spin around, they actually oscillate. Okay, your opening for the fertilizer isn't on the bottom. The agitator, as I spoke about, is an oscillating agitator. So to understand that, basically in the funnel at the end of the spreader, the shutters are on the side, not at the bottom, and the oscillating agitator works over back that way.
Okay.
So that means then that even if you stop on a headlamp, it can happen, the phone can ring, you're on the headlamp, the fertilizer spreader is running. If it's a circular system, if the fertilizer can be crushed or damaged or whatever, and then when you open up, you have a lot of dust that comes out. With an oscillating agitator, you don't get that.
Right,
so it's much freer. So when we go in here then, your side shutter opens up here, feeds the fertilizer down, using the arm here, places it onto the disc, or width, then is worked from that. What you have here then is you have epsilon vanes. So you see the way that these are like this?
Yeah.
The reason for that is that helps greatly with your section control. Because as the fertilizer has been fed out, you can control certain widths using the epsilon vein, and also the wear pattern and the wear on this is much, much better because you're splitting up the direction of travel. And again, that's also on your border spread then.
Okay.
Yeah, look, Jonathan, we've had a really good look around the spreader. We've been through everything else. I think it's time now to actually let's go get our loaded up, get it calibrated, and get you out there spread. The spreader quite a while now, so what's your conclusion? How have you gotten on?
Conclusion is it's now autumn time, we're standing in a field of oilseed rape. It was sowed in the middle of August, and I'm really pleased with the spreader. It's very even, there's no overlaps, and the crops have been even all year, so I'm really pleased with the spreader.
So you've seen a massive difference in how the section control works, the accuracy of the spreader, even how much fertilizer you're using.
Yes, so the cost of fertilizer this year has went up,
and I've saved a lot of money with using this floor.
John, it's been a pleasure working with you.
Thank you very much.
I really, really appreciate everything you've done. I hope you have a great, great time with that spreader. And hey, just a little bit from me to you.
Thank you very much.
Welcome to the L team.
Thank you very much.